My life is a stressful dumpster fire. So, like, there are occasional days when I just can't carve out the time to record and edit. And I did actually record something yesterday, but then it was going to take way longer to edit than I really have today to do. And then to do another one. Anyways, Internet Jesus is here to save the day. Carly has dropped a new video. It's called This Isn't Cringe, It's Criminal. And as you guys know, I'm a nosy biz. As always, the original video is in the description below. Please click on the link and support it, because we love Charlie. He's a very smart man. And don't... let's not piss off Internet Jesus. Please? And... don't piss me off either! Click like and subscribe on mine, or I'll, you know, you don't really have to. I'll be fine. It's fine. Use your own discretion. Take it away.
Over the last couple of months, I've analyzed more text messages than the FBI. I've been glued to bad romance and flirting, like a moth to a flame. I've been wandering the deepest, darkest pits of filth. It's like in Space Jam when Michael Jordan gets sucked into the golfing hole. I've been sucked into the...
is this an AI girlfriend? I would think Internet Jesus is... I pronounced you Internet Jesus, bro. Try harder.
Asshole of the internet, and all I see is cringe down here. But today there's a new ingredient being added to this concoction. The recipe had a chemical X. Crime. Aww. This got posted to Reddit earlier today, and a lot of people...
hold on, let's read. Hey, hello? Is this Blankety? Who it is? It's Bopadaba. Just wanted to text you and see how things were. Oh, things are going all right, I suppose. Not to come off as rude, but how did you get my number, dude? I mean, I don't mind you texting me, but I've never gave it to you. I just grabbed it off the contact sheet in the office room. Hope that's all right. How's it going, Bopada? Or beep-a-deep? A doop-a-doop? Blankety-blank? I don't remember what I named the first person.
Sent it my way, and it actually reminded me of a real criminal case that happened back in 2022.
Uh-oh.
And I actually found the case again through the comment section of this post, because I couldn't quite recall all the particulars.
I'm assuming there's more than
but
just
there's
that
a lot of similarities
message.
Shared between that criminal case in 2022 and these text messages that this individual is showcasing here.
I'm gonna be honest, guys, I don't want this to sound weird. I really dig true crime, because the best way, I think, to not get yourself murdercated is to study the murdercators so they can't murdercate you. I think that seems scientific. Comment below if you would like to see more true crime on the channel. I do get very ranty, though. I get hecka angry.
So it starts with this girl's coworker messaging her out of the blue saying, hey...
okay,
he receives crickets.
Cold.
No response. Silence. And you know what they say, if at first you don't succeed, try being weirder.
Oh,
so he
no.
comes back around within 3 hours saying, hello? Is this blank? She says, who
Blankety.
Is this? And he goes, it's me, with a smiley face. I just wanted to text you and see how things were. Oh, things are going all right, I suppose. Not to come off as rude,
yeah,
but how did
you
get my number, dude? I mean, I don't mind you texting me, but I've
wait! I'm sorry. I didn't read properly. I mean, I was too busy reading it out loud and not processing. You took her number off the fucking contact sheet in the office? You suck. That's not cool. That's like for like, I don't even know.
Never gave it to you. And that's when he lifts up the curtain and breaks the magician's code, revealing his secret method. I just grabbed it off the contact sheet in the office room.
I was worried
that
one of
right.
her friends had given it to
him.
I'm like, bad friend.
She says nothing in response because that is fucking creepy.
Yeah, that's not
she
cool.
Never gave him her number. He just went out of his way to find it from their workplace.
No.
Yucky. But he comes
back
around.
Upon actual brain power dedicated to this moment, I told you we were here to learn to be smarter, didn't I? Anyways, don't fucking do this. This is real weird. Don't. I know none of you would do that, but oh.
I'm saying, how's it going? And he just keeps going, throwing questions at the wind here, hoping to receive even the slightest semblance of life on.
Okay. As a person of the feminine persuasion, this is scary, bro. This is. We're venturing towards dudes will do anything but get therapy.
On the other side, not realizing that he has already scared her by snooping.
Okay, I'm sorry, I've got, let us ingest the cringe! Though I wonder, I'm worried Charlie will read it in a moment, and then I'm just gonna look like a dum-dum.
Around let's tracking see. Down let's her give him phone a number without ever getting it from her
directly.
Me. I don't
want to be outside,
so it's already super creepy to do that. So he says, how was your New Year's? No response. 2 days later. Sorry to keep texting, but what are you up to today? If you're free later, I'd love to go out. I will never understand that kind of shit right there. How can you be so deluded and lost in your own little fantasy land Narnia that you think there's even an iota of a chance that she agrees to go out with you when she has ignored your messages for 4 fucking days?
No.
Like,
you know what? We gave Sup Caitlin a good, strong ration of shit when we reacted to the last Charlie video. I warn you, there is a storm a brewing, and it is full of ranting. I'm trying to temper it with the wisdom of the 2 brain cells that I retain. However, I might be losing the battle. We'll see.
What is the thought process?
There is none.
Maybe she's playing hard to get. Perhaps she's just been truly swamped and has been really wanting to reply to me, but just might be a bit shy and doesn't know how. I know. I'll go ahead and invite her out with me. That should make her a lot more comfortable.
Oy.
And he goes a bit deeper. I know you're probably busy, but I could pick you up too, so you wouldn't
That's
have to
so
take the bus anywhere.
Uncomfortable.
If you wanted to go out, that is. Sorry to keep texting, but I don't want to be out too late, so I'd appreciate a response at some point, Smiley.
No, dude.
I'm heading out to get coffee now, so if you want to join me, just let me know. Ma'am.
No response is a response. This is going straight to HR on Monday because you've literally taken this girl's phone number from work for not like a coworker. Like, you took it from a piece of paper that I presume was supposed to be used for management or to contact other employees in case of an emergency or something. And then you used it to try to, like, strong-arm a date. Anything but therapy.
You better hurry. The choo-choo train is leaving and Mr. Perfect is going with it. You only have one opportunity
darn.
To get coffee with a gentle sir like this,
Yuck.
So you really gotta play your cards right.
Icky.
She declines, saying, I would appreciate it if you didn't text me unless it's work-related.
Good
I don't really
girl.
Know you, and I'm only blank. You're 5 years older than me, dude. This just feels creepy. I didn't mean to be...
Okay. This just hit a different pitch. I don't know what the age blanked out is, but I don't like it. Beyond that, she's, before we go any further with this message, she has set strong boundaries, not in a mean way, just in a very firm, like, this isn't appropriate, I don't want to deal with this, and I would appreciate it if you stopped this. Literally, she said, I would appreciate it. So, like, we're done here, this is where the line is, you've shot your shot in the creepiest of ways, but, no is a full answer. No response is actually also a full answer. She has no obligation to talk to you. She does not owe you a goddamn thing. Oh, God, here we go.
To be creepy or anything, you're just pretty, and I thought it would be cool if we got to hang out, Smiley. No thanks. That's honestly so weird. And if you continue to ask, I'm going to talk to Lean about this. I'm assuming that's like their supervisor
I would already be on the phone.
And then he goes in deep. He says, I'm not gonna lie. I've been thinking about you a lot, and I just want you to spend time with me. What you said the other day just felt rude. At least try and give this a chance. I know you're probably not awake, but I've been up all night thinking about you.
No, bro.
Not going to lie.
No,
sometimes
bro.
Sometimes I like to take pictures of your ass while you're in the
draft. Oh, bro. What the fuck are we even doing here? This super reads like an Am I the A-hole story on Reddit that I would instantly decide was fake because it just seems too unreal to actually be possible. And yet, I mean, I guess there is still a chance that this is just, but this happens way too fucking much. And it honestly, like, it gets pretty scary when you're on the other side because you don't know where, like, you set the boundary and they don't care about that boundary. That's a dangerous precedent. And beyond that, you don't know how far this is going to go. How far are they willing to take this? Steal your stomachs, friends!
Jerk off to them in the bathroom.
Back, what? I take pictures of you. I know this. Okay, call every police officer. All of them. Every police officer. Mm-hmm. Gonna need other states to show up too. Maybe the National Guard.
I'll go ahead and take a courtesy pause here to give everyone a brief respite.
Don't worry, Charlie! I already created one artificially, because, oh my fucking god.
Let that nugget marinate in this sauce here, because he just dropped a real
speed
heavy,
run
spicy
terrifying
meatball on the plate. And when I first read it, I certainly wasn't ready for that, because that's just openly admitting to a crime.
No
shit.
I'm not
a sheriff or anything, but I'm pretty confident that that's illegal. He'd probably be
it
taken away
be.
In handcuffs if this information got out. Which it should. She should absolutely report all of this.
Oh god, I hope
now,
she did.
Somehow
like,
it actually only
just
gets
like a
worse
TikTok
from here.
Or something.
This is just the beginning.
What?
He's showing his true face, and man oh man, is it an extraordinarily ugly one.
Oh,
I
no,
know that's
no.
messed up, but imagine if we fucked in the work bathroom, or if we went out in public. I honestly just love the idea of having a little helpless bitch under my control. I know you're
Let me out of the space prison. Oh, good Jesus fucking Christ. Listen, there's a point where there's time to make jokes about get to therapy, but there's a point where it's just time to, like, oh, good God. If you or anyone you know are in an unsafe situation, please talk to people about it. Talk to people you trust about it. Talk to people around you about it as you feel safe, as you feel comfortable. These situations do get very serious. They do not care about your gender. They don't care if you're male, female, envy. They don't give a fuck. These situations can happen to anybody. Please be safe. Okay? Thank you. That's my PSA. Okay. Trigger warning for the rest of this. I guess I should have started off with one, but take care of yourself. If you need to watch another video, I will hopefully we'll react to fuzzy animals tomorrow, okay? But aminals, we'll find an aminal video or something. Maybe tomorrow's gonna be a good meme day. Anyways,
so
back
much
to
younger,
cringe.
You should give it a shot. Older men can be so much fun to be
you
with.
You need to go
no
to
one
jail.
No at work would have to know. Hello? Sorry for calling, but I'm really lonely and you haven't replied to me at all.
Since yeah, what do you think that means, bud?
Text messages are going unanswered. I guess he's resorted to actually just calling her, which is also being ignored, obviously.
This is blatantly harassment at this point. Like, even if nothing else is technically somehow...
I can't believe the revelation that it turns out he's lonely. Who would have seen that coming? With smooth talking like this, this dude's got all the game in the world. This man's a fucking apex predator. A grizzly bear. Champion is here. I can't believe that he, of all people, would somehow be lonely. What a curveball. He then tries to brush all that under the rug, trying to apologize for it. Sorry about last night. I got carried away. I know you're probably not even reading these, but I hope you have a good day, Smiley.
You disgusting fuck.
I really don't see an issue. It's not like a romantic
date. I don't even want to say that, because for fuck's sake, this person probably has some kind of shame kink. That's the only imaginary, it's the only realm in which you do this shit. There's no fucking way.
Or anything. It would just be getting coffee and food. And if you were in the mood, we could always go to my place to watch a movie. I know it sounds creepy, but why not just get out and enjoy the day together? What in the hell is even that? What are you talking about? It's not like a romantic thing or anything.
Fucking jail.
You were just talking about fucking in the workplace bathroom.
No shit.
And then you were talking about having a helpless bitch under your control. What do you mean?
Yeah, what does that fucking mean, bud?
You're already showing how extraordinarily creepy and perverse you are. What are you yapping about? He's blabbermouthing about a bunch of hooey.
Angie.
And that's when she finally does respond to all this and says, "All right, man, I'm probably going to report you to the police. You know damn well that I'm underage
Good
and you're texting
girl.
Me in the middle of the night like that. Fuck off." And then he drops her address
what?
And says, "If you continue to ignore me, I'll just make it so you can't. If you tell anyone, I'll make this even worse for you." So it turns out she's
they're going to have a great fucking time with you in prison, bud. Just the amount of... This is the stupid fucking Olympics. I don't give a fuck what's wrong with you. If you think this is acceptable, you're broken. And I'm sorry, I don't throw that word around, but that's... Go... Somewhere, get something that I don't. I'm gonna have to cut all this out. This guy's a fucking dumbass. Let's take out all of the disgustingness from this and focus on the fact that this fucking moron has texted this from, I assume, his own personal fucking phone number. Like, all of this is, and then he just straight out threatens her. Like, are you speedrunning jail? What are we doing?
He was well aware of that fact. And he also would have been even more aware of that fact, considering he snooped through the confidential workplace documents to find her address.
How
and her
was
phone
he
number.
Able to do
so
this? Okay, now it sounds like the workplace could potentially be sued for this, because how the fuck was he able to get to that? If it's supposed to be confidential, he shouldn't have access to it.
Abundantly clear that she is underage, and he didn't care. He still went for this full throttle. So he's also a pedophile on top of all of this.
Great.
He concludes their conversation by dropping her address to obviously try and scare her, letting her know that he knows where she lives and he can always pay her a visit.
Dumbass.
And a lot of people in the comments, and I think a lot of people in general, would assume that that's just supposed to be like some kind of scare tactic to get her to not say anything. Not necessarily that he's going over there right this instant to do something, but that is still a legitimate threat.
Yep.
And I imagine an actionable threat that the authorities can use. This is one of
those... I would like to high-five Charlie with our brains. I don't know how to do that, but just mentally, like, you know, brain five. Yep, that was dumb. Let's continue watching.
Situations that really shouldn't be taken lightly, and it seems like it isn't. It seems like she's taken the proper measures here.
I'm so happy with like Herbie, like
that, which is
her
what
response
she should be
to
doing,
all this is
because
perfect.
This is just legitimately dangerous. I mentioned at the start that it reminded me of a case from 2022 where a man killed his 17-year-old coworker because he had a huge crush on her, and since he couldn't have her, nobody could. Her name was Riley Whitelaw, and she was murdered at her place of work by this individual. He recently got sentenced in October of 2023 for the murder, and it is just horrifying. Now, Riley had...
I kind of mentioned this a little bit earlier. That's when people will talk about how situations escalate and get dangerous. I know plenty of you know this, but to the one person who might hear me and go like, "Oh, maybe I should take this weird situation a little bit more seriously." This can escalate. I'm not trying to scare anybody. This can escalate. This can get much worse. Please do what you need to do to tell people around you to get some help going. And I. Wow, I thought this was gonna be a little fast, little Charlie video. Fuck!
Previously made a complaint to the employment about how uncomfortable he made her with, like, the advances that he would make on her and all of that, and even asked to, like, have her schedule change so they wouldn't have to work together. And despite all of that, they still worked together.
Are you fucking joking?
The place of employment did not change her schedule around to get her...
Okay, they can absolutely be sued now. Jail!
...from him or anything like that.
Jail for everybody!
...to work together despite all of her complaints until it eventually culminated with him killing her. It's a tragic
story.
Oh,
that was the other one, but still.
And
jail.
It reminds me of the text messages we just read right there, where a coworker becomes infatuated with someone and then eventually does something disgusting like that. So reading through these text messages, it is a concerning individual in a scary situation. And it's something I think about from time to time about how awful it must be to just be doing your job, doing nothing wrong at all, and then still ending up in a situation like this. This girl never made any advances toward this guy. She never even gave him her number or anything at all. And yet somehow he still became obsessed with her and then stalked her company documents to find her phone number and her address and all of that. It's just so awful. She's literally just doing her job and then put in a situation like this because of this absolute lunatic. So yeah, just wanted to talk about it a little bit. I think situations like these should always be taken seriously. Like if a coworker or anyone for that matter starts to get like a level of obsession with you that it becomes a bit palpable that you can start to see it, it immediately needs to be something that you take very seriously because you never know where it could lead. And I think that is just always something that needs to be handled with real care. So just
wanted
to go over this a little bit. That's really it. So yeah.
I'm going to add on a little bit here. This happens all too often. It doesn't care about gender. It doesn't care about identity. Like, there are unfortunately some people that need to get assistance, and I would love for that to be the end of their story instead of anything like this. But I'm glad this girl is taking it seriously. I very much hope her work is also taking it seriously and something negative happens to this person. But I do hope that everyone in this situation is safe and gets the assistance that they need, that this does not become an issue. I know this was a little bit of an odd video today, but I appreciate all of you for hanging out with me all the same. Stay safe out there. Foxy cares about you. And I won't be as late tomorrow, I promise. Bye!